What's up, guys? Milik here, and today we are back in action playing some Arkmon. It's going to be freaking amazing. If you guys enjoy, make sure to smash the like button. I'd really appreciate it and help me out tremendously. So last time we actually tamed a, we bred two beautiful dragon godlings with Riot. We made a baby, and then we also got a Diplodocus. This time we're going to try to get some more basic creatures, I guess. It should be pretty sweet. So we got a bunch of name suggestions. I think what we're going to name this guy is, well, let's go through some of the name suggestions first. We got Derplodocus. Derplodocus. We got Big Green Taxi. We got Fat Bastard from Austin Powers. We could name him Fat Bastard. I kind of like that, actually. But we also got, there was one person that said the egg. There was two or three people that said the egg looked like a potato. So I thought potato might be a good name for this guy. No one actually suggested it as a name, though. But I thought it'd be kind of funny. We could either name this guy Potato or Fat Bastard. Maybe we'll name him Fat Bastard. that would be kind of funny. Let's go. Let's just try it out. See how it looks. Fat Bastard. Yes. So that's what this guy's name is now. Let's go ahead. I think I'm going to do. Let's do some movement speed. Oh wow, he has a lot of levels. There we go. Well, two levels. The Diplodocus is definitely very, very cool. I like that it has the stomp or whatever. You got this guy. Are you going to do it? Yep, you got the tail whip, and then you got the beautiful stomp right here. For some reason, I am receiving major lag / ping on the server right now. Yeah, there we go. Nice. That we're going to name him Fat Bastard, I guess, or I could rename him Potato or something. Let's go ahead and come over here to the baby. Now, the baby is a female. Let's go ahead. I think the name that we got that I liked the most was Erida, which apparently is the goddess of hate and is like Ares' brother, even though this isn't the way the family tree works. I still thought it was pretty good. Let's see. Erida. Yeah, there we go. So I thought that was a pretty good name. I guess we're going with the god theme for the dragon gods. I mean, it makes sense. They're both gods. Well, I guess, I don't know. Maybe the dragon gods would be considered like demigods because, you know, they're obviously not all powerful and that kind of stuff. Let's go ahead and, So last time we also started working on the crop plots. I did plant our narcoberry seeds. Unfortunately, we didn't at the time have any fertilizer, but off camera, I kind of slowly started working on fertilizer. So what I made is I made the thatch and fertilizer silo. Now what this does is this actually, you put thatch in here and it automatically puts thatch inside of compost bins. I made large compost bins, which is also another, CV mod. So what happens is it puts thatch in here. It takes the thatch and poop from. It takes the thatch from this guy. It takes the poop from this guy. This guy automatically collects poop from around our whole base here. It makes fertilizer. Then the fertilizer gets put back inside of this guy, and it's kind of like an automated process. So the only thing we really have to add to this is thatch. Now the better way of doing this is actually using the resource crop mod plots, and then that will like automatically make stuff. So let's just go ahead and grab some of the fertilizer here, and then we're going to come over here and stick in the crop plots. Yes, and we shall have some beautiful stuff here. Let's go ahead and just put three in each of these guys. And this is a good way to actually get narco berries. Now we're going to take the narco berries and our new futuristic technology of spoiling meat and start making some things. That way we can make some 30cc darts. So let me work on this for a while. Actually, what did 30cc require? I can't remember, actually. Okay, so we have some berries. Let me go ahead and grab out all of this rotten meat right here, or spoiled meat, I should say. Did I grab both of it? Yes, I grabbed all of it. I'm going to stick in here. We're going to see how much we can actually make just with this little amount of berries. Now, getting berries is probably the easiest part. Actually, I guess getting spoiled meat is easier now. They're about the same, I guess. Let's go ahead and make some narcotics. We can make over 100. Yeah, there we go. So 150. That's not that bad. Okay, never mind. That's not that bad. It requires 10 narcotics. Okay, 10 narcotics, 1 polymer, 1 metal ingot, and 20 rare flowers. So the only thing we're really missing is the rare flowers, and then we need to mass get narco berries. Now, the best thing for this job would probably be a Bronto. But we do have a Diplodocus, but maybe we'll try to tame a Bronto today as well, just because that would be very, very easy in gathering berries. So I'm going to pause it. I think we're going to go out and look for some stuff to tame, and I will be right back. Actually, real quick, before we go tame stuff, I kind of want to make a jetpack. That's something we haven't done yet this season. So we need a jetpack research station, and this is actually the better jetpack mod, at least in my opinion. I like this one better than the other one, but I haven't played with the other one in a while, so I'm not sure. It might be better now. Let's go ahead and grab this guy, and I'm just going to stick the jetpack research station down here somewhere. Are you gonna place? Yes, there we go. We'll just place that guy right there. Boom! And then we need to see how much the jetpack actually costs. Let's see. Armor, jetpack, yes. So polymer, metal ingot, gunpowder, and gasoline. Okay, so we have metal ingot. We have polymer. We just need gunpowder and gasoline. I actually don't think I have any gunpowder, but I'm pretty sure I do have gasoline. Yeah, we got plenty of gasoline. And then as for the gunpowder, I'm not really sure, to be honest. Maybe we might have some in here that I've got from drops. It could be randomly spread around, but we could just go ahead and make gunpowder real quick. And there we go. We have some gunpowder. I'm also, I also have been gathering all of my narcotics off all my creatures, and it's doing pretty good. I think I have a bunch more, actually. So the only thing we're really missing is rare flowers, because narcotics is a pretty common drop off of crates and just creatures in general. So rare flowers, we need to either go to beaver farms or just harvest them like normal. Okay, guys, we're back. So I have found a saber tooth out in the wild, a fire one that's actually pretty high level. That's pretty cool. It's here on the island somewhere. But I thought we would come back. I'm going to make some, I think it's Bronto eggs that the saber tooths need. So I'm actually currently making Bronto eggs. Let's go ahead and look at this guy, or Bronto kibble, I should say. So yeah, that should be good to tame the saber tooth, and we'll get that beautiful, perfect 100% tame. Now, I did make the jetpack. We'll test that out here in a second, but one thing I want to do is I want to make, we're starting to get a bunch of creatures, and I'm going to make a pimped smithy so we can get all the cool saddles. Now, I want to make a frog saddle, I want to make a saber-tooth saddle, and then we need to make a couple T-Rex saddles as well. Are you going to craft, man? Yes. Okay, thank you for crafting. Hopefully, it doesn't craft two of them. The server is still lagging very slightly. I'm not sure why. Let's go ahead and grab this guy. Yes, and then we can stick the pimp smithy really anywhere we want to. I might just go ahead and start sticking stuff over here as well. Let's just grab this guy. We need to stick this perfectly in the corner. Let's make sure that this is pretty straight. Actually, let me go in K mode here. We got to make sure that this is good. This looks pretty good, actually. Let's back away from the wall a little bit. Yes, we want to make sure that it doesn't clip through. And we shall stick that right there. Nice! I'm going to go ahead and stick a bunch of this stuff inside of here. I brought all of the hide from all of my creatures. We have a bunch of keratin and metal and wood. I'm not sure what we're going to need for all this stuff, but I'm just sticking random things in here. So we need Sabertooth. Let's just go ahead and look up Sabertooth. We have a Sabertooth metal saddle, which gives 75 armor. So we need fiber to make that, and then we have the saber sign. I actually might make all the signs and stick them up here. That'd be kind of neat. Let me grab some fiber real quick. Okay, so we got some fiber. Also, a server message just popped up that says there's a mod update, and it's restarting in 15 minutes. So that's beautiful. Let's come over here, and I'm going to make the Sabertooth saddle. Hopefully, it saves my progress. If it doesn't, then I'm going to be very angry. So Sabertooth, nice. We'll just go ahead and make one of these guys since we know we're going to be taming a Sabertooth. And then we also want a frog saddle. So is this, so we have the chitin one. Let's go ahead and make this guy, yeah. Nice. And then we need some T-Rex saddles. Now, I think the T-Rex saddles actually, let's see, T-Rex. We can make, so for the Rex saddles, we have enough, actually. It requires, we'll make two of these guys since we have two T-Rexes. Nice. So we have a frog saddle, a saber-tooth saddle, and two freaking things, Rex saddles. Nice. Okay, so we got one Rex saddle. Once I start getting some dyes, we'll actually start dyeing these saddles as we kind of like tame the creatures. That way, all the creatures will have beautiful saddles, and we don't have to worry about coloring like 47,000 creatures here. But yeah, there we go. We have the Pimp My Rex saddle. If you guys have never seen this mod, it is by far one of the most fantastic armor mods for Ark. It's amazing. Like the Rex saddle here looks absolutely fantastic. These are the saddles we need for Vanilla Ark right here. These are the cool saddles. They're coming out with a second update that's supposed to have like tech tier armors for all the creatures and that kind of stuff. And I think they're going to do armors for most of the current creatures that are in the game right now. So I'm really excited about that. Actually, I made a post on my MediaLock Facebook because the Pimp My Dino Armor mod has a Facebook page as well. And they posted pictures of like the tech Rhino saddle and all that kind of stuff. And it looks freaking amazing. It looks fantastic. So there we go. We got that. Where is my frog at? I put my frog somewhere. I think we're going to tame the Sabretooth with the frog. Yeah, Kiwi. What's up, man? Okay. Let's go ahead and stick this guy inside of you. Nice. We have a look at this. The frog saddle makes him look like a little Japanese warrior. He looks amazing. Look at him. He looks sweet. And we can color this. I'll probably like color match it. So this will be like green and black and you know, they're kind of the same colors as the frog here. But yeah, it looks definitely really, really cool. Look at this. The saddles are amazing. I love the Pimp My Dino saddles. Okay, guys, we're back. So, we're going to go tame the Sabretooth that I saw down here. I need to find it first, though. Anunnaki just now came out with an update. They, like, changed some, I guess, Wyvern/Drake breath ranges and done all that kind of stuff. Also, they actually reverted the Drake textures, which I think the old Drake textures look worse than the new Drake textures. So, I don't know. I'm kind of sad about that. I really like the new Drake textures. There's two freaking Sabretooths here. Oh my god, just go down, man. Just freaking go down. Also, I forgot to mention, I think what I was talking about last time, I put like a little thing up on the video. Yeah, you need to go down. Or you could just run away, that's fine as well. Oh, here's the other one. Okay. I'm pretty sure this is the high. Oh, okay, we got two of them here. What's up, guys? what's up, guys? Psycho is apparently sick. So they're not going to be adding any new content until he gets better to Anunnaki Genesis, which kind of sucks. He's the sole like mod developer. I think Alice helps him do some specific things, but I'm not sure what those things are. But yeah, he's like the main sole developer of Anunnaki Genesis. Dude, just go down. There we go. Oh, he's 585. Nice. Okay, let's go over here and kill this guy real quick just so he doesn't come back up and try to murder me. Let's just eat his insides. Anunnaki Genesis won't be adding any new content for a while, which is kind of sad. But I really hope Psycho does feel better. I don't know how he's sick or whatever, but if it's going to prevent him from making a mod, I just want to say I wish you the best, man. Hopefully you watch this. I really hope you get better and, you know, take your time. I'm in no rush, and I'm sure a lot of other people care about your well. Oh, dude, this kibble tames fast. I'm sure a lot of other people really care about your well-being, man, and I really hope you get better, and just take all the time you need. Dude, the mod is amazing right now, so you know, I'm not really too worried about it, but I really do hope you get better, dude, and I appreciate all of your hard work on the mod so far and that kind of stuff. But bring back Drake textures. I like the Drake textures. Apparently, everyone was saying, or a bunch of people were saying Drake and Wyvern textures cause lag. I'm not sure. I didn't really notice anything. But I never encountered a wyvern, so I have no idea. I don't have any idea. But yeah, we have a fire saber tooth now. This is going to be getting keratin and chitin and leather and meat and all that stuff way easier. I think what we're going to do is we're going to head out. We're going to try to find a Bronto. Actually, let's read the stats real quick. So 7,300 health, 2,500 stamina, 1,200 weight, 800% melee damage, and 130% movement speed. So we're going to head out. We're going to try to find a Bronto, preferably a champion Bronto, and we're going to try to tame that guy. Actually, for that, we might need a Rex. But what I might do is I might head out on the Sabretooth and level him up, and then if we find a Bronto, I'll like grab my Rex and we'll like use him to knock him out. So if you guys care about, you know, mod developers and, you know, mods and stuff like that, go to the Anunnaki Steam forums and go wish Psycho good health. Like, go say, you know, what's up, man? I wish you the best of luck and hopefully you get better soon, and I really love your mod, and, you know, give them some support. You know, these guys make mods for free and they do it, you know, out of the kindness, out of their heart. You know, I mean, some mod developers, they actually use that as a way to get into the industry, and that's actually how a lot of people, you know, work on Skyrim and stuff like that. They used to be mod developers, which is pretty sweet. But, you know, they do all this stuff for free. They don't get any money out of it, and if they get a little bit of money, it's very, very, very small. So, you know, the difference between the kind of, I don't know, mod developers are really good people. They do all this stuff for free. They make amazing content, and they're really passionate about what they do. So, you know, just go say, you know, hello, I love your mod, man. So that would be freaking amazing. Anyways, we are out searching for Brontos. I've actually brought some carbo kibble with me. We got some turtle kibble. I have a little bit of berries. I'm not sure if this amount of kibble and berries is going to be enough. I probably should have went and harvested some berries. But we're looking for a Bronto and or a champion Bronto as well. So I don't know where champions. I'm not sure if I've even seen any champions. I think German said he's seen champions. So we're just going to go to see where Brontos are and hopefully find a high-level champion. I want to find it. I want to find a Bronto that's at least over level 500. I'm not sure if we're going to be able to find a champion that's over 500, though. But we're going to look around. I went ahead and made a Bronto saddle as well. So I'm just going to. Brontos usually spawn. Actually, there's Brontos over at the Snow Mountain, isn't there? I think. Let's head over to the Snow Mountain. We're going to look around, and I'll be right back once we find one. Or something similar, something like that. Okay, guys, we're back. So, I have not found a champion Bronto, and I checked the Ice Mountain. There were zero Brontos on the Ice Mountain over there. But I have finally found an over-level 500 Bronto here. I have not seen any champions at all, so I'm not sure where champions spawn or if they're just really rare or what. I'm assuming they're just rare and they spawn where a normal Bronto spawn. But we do have this guy right here, which is going to make life way easier, especially getting berries and stuff. We might also take him to the swamp and just mass swing in all the trees. That'd be pretty cool. And then get like rare mushrooms and that kind of stuff. So let's try to knock this guy out. Now the thing is we could try to do with... let's just knock him out with the frog. He shouldn't be that bad to knock out. And the Brontos don't do that much damage, so especially to badass creatures. So we should be able to knock him out decently fast. Now, I'm not sure like how much torpor this guy has, but we're just going to mass click on him until he falls over. As you can see, he's doing very, very little damage. Now, this would be faster if I had like a Drake or a T-Rex or something. Or if I made the 30cc darts, but you know, I haven't got that far yet. So I guess what we'll do is we'll try to use darts here pretty soon once I actually is he running away? Is he running away? What's up, man? What's up, dude? You need to go down? Yes. Yes, go down. Okay, he's running away. So that means he's probably about to fall down. Okay, the only thing we need... Yeah, and he is down. Nice. Okay, so he's down. Hopefully no bugs attack me. How much torpor did you have, dude? 66,000. Okay, let's go ahead and give you one of these guys. We're going to give you some kibble. Sweet. You should... Oh, God. That's not going to be enough, is it? That's not going to be enough. I need a golden trait. Wait, no, maybe... that's going to be... We're going to get at least half. I'm going to gather some berries, though, just in case. I kind of ran out of metal or I would have made more stuff. Let me gather some berries real quick. Okay, so looks like he got about halfway with the kibble. The rest of this is going to be berries. What I'm going to do is this is going to ruin his tame very, very slightly. But I am going to give him these berries here. So the way it works is kibble is the best, obviously. Well, golden treats are the best because of Anunnaki Genesis. But kibble is the second best besides golden treats. Then it goes vegetables, which I don't have any yet because I just now put a fertilizer in those guys. Then it goes meho berries, and then it goes the rest of the berries. So that's the order everything actually worked. You know, we're going to be fine. It's 99.4%. He's high level. He's going to gain a lot of levels. He's going to be very, very good. But just to make sure, I'm going to gather some more berries, though, just to be 100% certain. Okay, so he should be decently close to taming now. I've been slowly gathering berries. It's been about, I don't know, 15 minutes or so. He tames very slowly on berries. I should have made about double the amount of kibble. I'll remember that for next time. But he's definitely very, very close. He's not going to lose that many levels at all either. He's going to be over 700. Around 750, probably. Maybe 770, something like that. He's going to be still pretty, really, really good. I guess we can... Oh, wait, what's this dragon god over here? Now, I've been seeing a lot of dragon gods, but I think we're going to try to tame a Blackheart Godling maybe next time. And there we go! We have a Bronto. Awesome. Okay, so level 791. Okay, sweet. Nice, nice, nice. Let's go ahead and give him the saddle. Boom! We have a Bronto platform saddle. Are you going to follow me, Kiwi? Kiwi, I need you to follow me, man. Yeah, there you go. You're following me. Now, let's see what damage this guy can do. Yes! 200 narco berries, baby! Let's head to the swamp. Oh my god, he is so slow. I completely forgot how slow the Bronto is. Then Kiwi, oh my god, Kiwi, stop. You know what? We're just going to attack this guy. We're just going to attack this guy. Yep, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Paraceratherium. You're just going to have to go down, man. You're just going to have to die for your crimes against mankind. Also, this is a good way to get thatch and a little bit of wood as well. I mean, it's not the greatest way to get wood and thatch, but it's still pretty good. Now, the swamp is really where we're going to be getting a lot of resources at. Resources that we need, anyways. Yes, go down, Paraceratherium. No one likes you. Oh, and the frog has knocked him out. Please, Dragon God, don't come over here. Yeah, there we go. Bronto has killed a Paraceratherium. Let's go ahead and give him some more damage and maybe some movement speed. I'm not really worried about his health. Only three stats I'm worried about is weight, melee damage, and movement speed. And I just want enough melee damage just so I can kill stuff and level this guy up. Let's give him how much? Okay, you get quite a bit of movement speed. Let's give you 150, and we're going to give you some melee damage. And he should be a little bit faster. Kiwi, get out of here. Oh, my God, Kiwi. Okay, I'm going to meet you guys at the swamp, I think. Okay, so we finally made it to the swamp. This Bronto is much slower than anticipated. I guess the champions are just fast in general. I should have went for it straight for the champion. But we're going to be able to get rare mushrooms and stuff here. And then I think, I'm not sure where the flowers spawn at. But if we can actually kill some flowers, we can get some rare flowers from those guys. Looks like I'm kind of stuck right now, though. Also, we might be able to get a lot of actual experience in the swamp as well. But anyways, I'm going to work on this for a while. I'm going to go ahead and pause it here. You guys are about to see some gameplay with me and German. We tamed some pretty sweet creatures, so hopefully you enjoy that. Also, later tonight, we should, whenever the Titanosaur update releases, we should either have tonight early in the morning or tomorrow sometime in the day have a Titanosaur update video. We're planning on actually doing some more Titanosaur videos, so be tuned for that. And yeah, I'll see you guys here in a second. Also, we need to avoid brood mothers. That's the biggest thing about the swamp here, is there's like four, or actually there's probably like six brood mothers. There's probably like a couple primals and then a couple normal brood mothers that are everywhere. So if we get attacked by those guys, we're pretty much dead. Rare flowers right there. Nice. That's exactly what we're looking for. And I think beavers are actually better for this kind of stuff, but actually, I can guarantee they're better. It'd probably be better just to bring a beaver down here. The Bronto cannot be beat by anything when it comes just getting berries and stuff in general. As you can see, we have over 2,000 meho berries, 2,000 narcotics, and that was in the forest. In the swamp, we're not going to be getting quite as many berries as we would in the forest, but yeah. Anyways, I will be right back. Okay, guys, we're back. So, I'm joined by that German guy, and we're going to try to tame some beautiful cryostasias.
Yes.
We're going to try to get two. We have one right here, and it's level, what was it, 625?
625, 628, something
yeah.
like that.
I'm on this guy just because I feel like the T-Rex is probably better able to tank this guy than the Drake is.
Yeah.
Plus, the goddesses, like, knock you down. Actually, you should have let me try to land real quick. See if I can bring you down here. Oh, never mind. It's going to make you land.
Yeah.
Wait, are you stuck or are you good? You stuck?
No, I'm good.
Okay, you're good? Okay, well, I'm gonna continually attack it, and then you can do whatever you want. I'm trying to get its attention from you. How much health does your Drake have?
I don't know. I've got 360,000.
You're not even helping right now. What are you doing?
I'm using a health booster.
Okay. Jeez, who gave you permission to use health boosters?
Now I'm killing this freaking spider.
Okay, we need to make sure. I'm gonna click slowly. Just so,
so we don't clip it.
Yeah, we don't cause it to,
Every time it goes into the ground to, like, bite you, I think it's going down.
Yeah, I know. It's like, I'm looking straight down right now. I'm actually getting dizzy. Do you ever get, like, sick, like, motion sickness from the screen shake? Or, like, maybe you're flying upwards and doing a spiral or something?
No. Only if, motion blur is on and I'm, like, hitting a rock or something with a hatchet. That will do it.
So, the Elder Dragon Gods here have around 500k torpor, usually.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm not sure if the cryo stages are the same. I'm assuming they're probably going to be similar, though. Is it?
It's running.
Come back here. You can't run away from me. Oh, my God. There's a thing in my way. It's in my way. I can't do anything. Okay, we're good.
All right. It grounded me, and it's on the ground again.
Okay, that's good.
Stuck in something.
I thought it was running away, but I guess not. Yeah, maybe it was just... It's like, I'm sick of you plebs.
I got bear stuff to do.
Yeah, I need to go eat stuff, okay? I need to go to, like, Burger Queen. And,
Burger Queen?
Yeah, copyright, TM, trademark.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah. I can't, and get the Mick Whipper.
Oh, gosh.
I need to go to Burger Queen and get the... Oh, that's sounded... Did we hit it? I didn't hit it.
I don't think so. Okay. I think I was too far away. Okay, so they used to like Quetz Kibble, so we can try that, but...
We can, but if you do a wrong kibble, it's going to cause their taming efficiency to go down.
Yeah, that's true. Do you want to just do Prime then? Hello? What's dragging me over here?
I'm not... 93% taming efficiency. That's actually good. I think... Wait, is something attacking right now?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, something's attacking right now. You have a thing!
I've got quite a few things.
85%? How much? 82%? 384,000 torpor. Do you want to, like, knock it back down, or...?
Yeah, I say we do. That is too much. Oh, do you want to test the Quetz Cable first, though?
Yeah, I guess we can.
Here, while I kill this stuff, just take out my Dragon's Inventory.
Okay. Well, I'm, I can't get close. What kind of kibble do you want me to do?
Quetz.
Okay, Quetz. But Dragon God mod did update, and it has,
its own kibble.
It has its own kibble now, but you need Dragon God Egg, so...
Yeah.
No, it doesn't cause its taming efficiency to go down at all, and it tames decently fast.
Okay, so yeah, we'll just use that next time.
Yeah, but it's down to like 40% taming efficiency, so yeah,
yeah,
we definitely...
Yeah, we gotta wake him up.
Wait, do you have a Divine Salt on you?
I do.
Nice. Well, use that. I'm gonna get back on my T-Rex real quick.
Oh, shit. We aggroed a bait. Oh, okay, it's already unconscious.
It's already down.
I just turned slightly, it's like... Bleh.
So, hey, since the update, have you tried the compound arrows yet? Because they boosted them or something. They're, like, 7,500% better or something? I don't know.
In the Anunnaki ones, you mean?
Yeah, the Anunnaki ones. No, I'm not sure.
Okay. Yeah, I hate the way the comp... Oh, there we go.
Oh, damn it. Oh, damn it. I hit it. I'm stuck on her, actually. Let's see. Let's see what the taming... As long as it's, like, 90-some%, I think it'd be pretty good. Oh, it already has food. Let's see. Let's just test it real quick. It's 97%. Yeah, it's good.
Okay, so I'm tossing the golden kibble.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, the golden treat. Yeah, I forgot about that.
Boom.
Yeah, I don't know why we were testing kibble before. But there you go, man.
Yeah, 929.
Yeah, that's actually pretty good. Nice. We're going to try to find another one. I want to get one.
This is female, right? Yeah, so now we need a male.
Yeah, we need a male, and
we
I want to get...
We need a male goddess.
We need a male goddess that's over level 700. So that's going to be that's going to be kind of hard.
Yeah, we'll do it. We'll find it.
Yeah, we'll find it. We'll get it. Okay, guys, so after like 47,000 hours of searching around the entire island...
Yeah, he's not actually kidding.
Yes.
We're both 70 years old now.
Yes, I have a gray beard. We actually went back in time and edited this video so it'd be out properly.
Yeah.
we actually found one up near my base, so that was kind of unfortunate or fortunate at the same time. I'm not exactly sure which one. Can you stick the artifact on these guys?
I think so.
So they can have the platform saddle or the artifact, I guess?
I think.
So these guys are supposed to have torpor. I don't know which one actually does torpor. I don't know if all their attacks do torpor or not.
I think it's the ice breath.
The ice breath? So we can actually test that out here in a second, like once we tame this guy. And this one's actually a male. That was our hardest problem, was finding a male. All the ones that we found were all females.
Out of 15.
I would say there's probably, I don't know if they have a percentage, but I would say it's probably like a 5 to 10%.
I spin around to get it, and then it goes behind me again.
Oh, yeah.
It's really irritating.
It's probably like a 5% chance, 5 to 10% chance for female or males to spawn, maybe. Either that or we were just unlucky. This guy is, what level was he? He's like, I think he's like a little
702 or 74 or something.
Yeah,
like that.
Something like that. I'm not sure exactly what he is, but he's higher levels, which is pretty sweet. So if we breed him, we'll have a pretty sweet baby. Also, I kind of figured out how the baby mechanics work a little bit, like the percentage on the boost you get. I had like 10% boost after the tame, because I think the boost goes down if you don't use it for a while, like if you don't play with them or whatever for a while.
Yeah, it does. People are asking that it doesn't, please.
Yeah. Well, after taming, it went down to like 10%, and I noticed it was about it was 9%, and it was about a 1.8% increase on stats.
Huh.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, nice. That was perfect.
Yeah, that was good. I think we got a perfect thing right here, man. Yeah, yep. 705.
Beautiful.
So I'm guessing it's going to be about 2% boost on all the stats every 10% taming efficiency or whatever. Or not efficiency, but... Oh, yeah, nice. Sweet, dude. Nice.
1,057. Look at that.
Yeah. Now, can I actually pick up the T-Rex?
That would be ridiculous.
No, I can't. No. Dude, this guy is ridiculously slow, man. Okay, guys, so I think we're going to breed these guys now. They do have hearts, so I'm guessing they're perfectly good. They're perfectly able to do this.
Yep.
Are you ready to enable wandering?
Sure.
Okay, let's do it now, I guess. Okay, actually, you did it on mine. That's fine. Oh. I did it on yours. That's fine as well. They're making babies. I'm going to start spamming you here. It looks like they're not really moving, though.
Yeah, they're just kind of chill.
Yeah, they're not actually moving at all. That's fine. They're probably going to try to move off here. Maybe they just really love each other. We actually...
Nope.
Oh, we're close.
This is like Pokemon.
I bet there we go. Yeah, I bet the egg looks all frosty. Look at this.
Yep, it is.
Too cold. Okay, so level 929 and level 1080. Let's disable wandering before they fly away and decide to start their own like clan or something. And then like plot their revenge on us later in life.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm going to throw the egg on here, man.
Where'd you go? Up here?
I'm over by my kibble machine and stuff.
I don't know where your shit is.
Well, hey, no. Also, whoever owns this pteranodon, I'm flying off the cliff. Okay, that was probably a horrible
idea. I was just waiting for you to go over the edge. I was just like, oh, please. Please just keep going.
Yeah. There we go. Oh, there we go. It finally picked up. Yeah, because I actually incubated on these before without the Jones egg collector, so it was just sideways on the thing. It was like, I thought it was going to be born deformed or something because it was all just lopsided the whole time.
It has a flat side of its head.
Yeah, it's just flat-sided.
Yeah. Why are you whistling at the egg?
I was taking a beautiful picture, okay? You don't judge. I don't know if I'm going to use that or not, but I just thought I would, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, don't judge me. Stop judging me.
According to Pyro, we're Power Rangers.
Why is your face all distorted?
Yeah, yours is too.
You look like...
It's like a piece of paper that's torn off to the side.
It's like, yeah, I'm a human. Look at this piece of paper on my mask. This proves that I'm a human.
It reminds me of Deadpool where he takes... At the end, she takes the mask off and he has the Wolverine face on.
Oh, yeah.
At least stapled to him. Oh, there it is. Oh, it's so cute.
I know. Yes.
We got it.
So we got one. It's level 1001, dude.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Pretty awesome.
I guess we can... What we'll do is we'll just say it's both of ours.
Uh-huh.
And we'll just... We'll have, like, you can have her on weekends, and I can have her on, like, Wednesdays and Tuesdays, and then she can just fend for herself every other day.
Okay.
What gender is it, actually? Let's see.
I don't know.
Do you want to imprint or do you want me to imprint?
You can imprint on it.
Okay.
Sucker, you're stuck with it.
Okay, I'm letting it die. It's dead. It just doesn't exist anymore.
It's so cute.
I know. It's adorable.
I want to see it fly. Does it fly yet?
I don't know. We can have it follow us. Here, follow me over here, beautiful little princess. Little print. No, no. Oh, my God. It's where the egg was sideways. She's retarded now.
Dude, it does. Okay, it slides. Okay, yeah. We've got some animations.
Wait, hey, come stand next to behind it, from where I'm facing right here.
Uh huh.
Okay, that's fine. You're horrible. I hate you.
Sorry, I was trying to ride it.
it's disable wandering. Yeah, there we go. But we have a beautiful little baby now. You know what we could do? We could turn. We can have like two. Are you gonna? You're disabled wandering. Why are you still walking?
Sliding around, man.
Yeah, she's a surfer. Or he's a surfer. Are you a male or female? You're a female.
Oh, wow. I forgot. Okay, jump boost high.
Yeah, it's a female. We can make one like a platform saddle, and then we can make another one like they can be like damage dealers or help knock things out or something. So apparently you can actually knock stuff out with these guys. We haven't tried. Or actually, I tried with the breath, and it didn't seem to work very well. So I'm not sure if that's true or not, but some people said these guys actually knock things out better than Drakes do, so they could be trolling or that could be true.
Well, let's go try it.
Yeah, I guess. Let me...
Oh, yeah? This Carnos.
Oh, yeah, dude. The Saber's definitely knocked out, man. Yeah, I just knocked out... Yeah, okay, so they do knock out stuff.
These Argents all went down.
Yeah, they do a lot of damage, though, so I guess you would... Huh. Yeah, dude, they do knock things out. Okay, that's really cool. I don't know if they're better than the Drakes, though. I guess it just really all depends.
Yeah. Oh, there's a badass Argent over here.
You probably wouldn't want to increase there. Oh, but I do have... I do more damage, though, with my legendary artifact I have on him.
Right.
So, I don't know if that affects the torpor or not. That's, like, some kind of... Dude, I wish, like, we could specifically... Me and Jeremy were talking about this earlier. I wish you could specifically test that.
Yeah.
Like, there was, like, a torpor training dummy or something. There was a damage one. Then there was, like, maybe, like... a fire one.
Oh,
or like
we killed him before we knocked him out.
Yeah, actually, no, he knocked out, but I just shot him again. Like, oh. He was falling over, and then...
No, yeah, no, that was the stagger. He was trying to fly and couldn't.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. No, we killed him before.
So, yeah, they do knock things out, so they might be good for taming.
Yeah.
I might just boost the melee damage like crazy. We could probably get the melee damage up really high and then try to, like, knock out Dodorexes and stuff instantly.
Oh, yeah, that could.
Yeah, because I doubt no matter what damage we get this to, it's going to, like, one-shot, like, Dodorexes, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
So we could probably get the... Oops. Oh, I leveled up again. Nice. I'm probably going to get my movement speed up to about 200%, maybe?
Yeah, these things are slow.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah, these things are really, really slow.
Mine's at 202 movement now.
Oh, nice. I think mine is at 190?
Oh, yeah, this is good.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
It's not the best, but it's good. I wonder how good these guys... Oh, dude, these guys are probably the best way to knock out Wyverns.
Oh, yeah.
Because they have, like, the artifacts have... Well, mine has a lot of armor and stuff.
Plus an Alpha Ankler here.
And they have a lot of health by default. What level is it?
I don't know.
Wait, where are you?
Back towards your base pillar.
Huh.
I'm so bad at spyglasses. 540.
Oh, I kind of want this guy, actually. Do you want to try and knock him out?
Yeah. I hope we don't kill him, because alphas are so squishy.
Yeah. Alphas are squishy.
Okay. There
you
go. He's
done. He's down. That was... Actually, let's see how much torpor he had. That might be able to help us judge a little bit. He had 19,000. Okay.
It's not too bad.
Oh, he's going down. I got sedatives.
I don't. Oh, all the cables and stuff are in my.
Let me. I have some prime. I'm gonna give him one piece of meat. Does it say what his taming efficiency is? 100%. Okay, sweet. Yeah. Okay. So, yeah, dude. Nice. So, Alpha Anklo. I'm kind of curious to see how much.
There you go.
Dude, alphas tame so much faster than badasses.
Yeah. Now he's shitting his pants.
Yeah, I don't know why though. Why are they?
They all do.
How good are alphas now at gathering resources?
I don't know. This guy's badass looking, though.
Yeah, I know. Alpha Anklos look sick.
What level is this Carno?
Bye-bye. I think I'm going to go make a saddle for this guy, and I'm going to see how much like he actually mines and stuff.
Nice.
All right. Okay, guys, I'm back. So the server is down right now. I'm going to go ahead and call it here, though. Make sure to post name suggestions for the Cryo God, the Alpha Anklo, the Badass Sabertooth, and then the new Bronto we got. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to smash the like button. I'd really appreciate it. It helped me out tremendously, and I'll see you guys in the next one.